Think running a day spa is all massages and relaxation?
There is nothing relaxing about owning a day spa.
But we're here to help. Siri spa owners know that being in the spa business isn't for the weak.
It takes hard work, planning, and just a bit of luck.
We should know because we've owned a successful day spa for over 20 years. Now we're opening up our playbooks and giving you the business insights to run your day spa rather than letting it run you. This is a Spapreneur podcast with Lynn Graves and Ramona Rice.
What's up, Spapreneur?
Howdy, folks. How y'all doing?
Guess what time it is, Ceci?
What time is it?
We're going to answer a Spapreneur question.
Oh, I love doing that. Who is our new member? She posted in Facebook.
I'm going to look it up because I'm not prepared.
She's got
So let's explain what we're doing. Now, for now on, we are going to answer, start right off the bat, unless there's something hilarious going on in our lives. Though there is always something hilarious going on.
I was going to say, and that is when?
We will be answering a question from our Facebook group. So if you're not part of our Facebook group, shame. Because it's a lot of fun.
It really is a lot of fun.
Well, there's some nonsense that's fun, but most of it's kind of serious. Like, there's no, like, we don't allow whiny biatches.
No.
Let me tell you this one. So, okay, you know that I have them ask questions. So when you get to the group, you have to answer questions. You just have to answer at least one or two. But just to make sure they understand. So there was this one girl, I guess she got added in by another person. And one of the questions I have is, do you understand that we are unconventional spa owners, that we like wine and foul language and Western medicine? And she proceeded to write me a paragraph. I should have screen clipped it about how all that was wrong. And I'm like, I was like, nope, you cannot be in our community.
No.
It's like, I'm sorry. She goes,
you know what my favorite coffee cup is right now? I love Etsy. I go on Etsy all the time.
Which is ironic because you don't drink coffee.
No, I don't. But they have this coffee cup that says, I say to the officer, no, officer, it's water in my cup. And he says, no, ma'am, it's wine. And she goes, damn, Jesus did it again.
Yay.
I thought that was cute. That's my kind of call.
Yeah, but no, seriously, she had like this whole thing about why it was wrong and all of a sudden I'm like, No, you cannot come in my group.
No, so, and God help us, she don't want to be in Rebecca's group either.
Yeah,
badass
massage. No. No. So dear Spapreneurs, you're welcome. I'm doing that for you to keep the group tight and good. All right.
Oh,
so
Lordy.
Our question today comes from Maggie. We're just saying Maggie. To protect the innocent.
Yeah.
Okay. That's a long one. Okay. So.
Well, basically, it's she's got two.
She's her third year of business.
Yes.
With her husband, which is great. Two locations are third year business.
Yes.
God bless you.
And she's looking for a new system that can communicate between both, that can handle gift certificates and memberships without her having to hand do everything. Okay. So. What I wanted to say is we use Millennium. I know some of you out there aren't fans of Millennium. I love Millennium. And
Millennium's
I love
really
the
good.
Support that they've given us. And they are designed for multiple locations.
I'll just say the Pizza Hut Massage is their booking program. And
yeah,
there's a reason why they invest in it.
And
it
has a good liability program as far as for accounting wise.
Mm-hmm.
And
here's all the things you can do with it. You can keep track of your products. You can keep track of your staff. You can put in there when their certifications are up. And it'll prompt you reminders of that. You can put your no-show list in there. You can put credit cards in there.
There's one in there. What's the word for
missed opportunities?
Missed opportunities when you can't get someone booked.
And so you can check. So if all of a sudden you can't get someone booked because the person isn't there on Saturday, so you can tell, you can then go show the massage therapist or the esthetician, hey, 20 people this month have requested you on a Saturday.
It also has a program in there that your therapist can go and just see their schedule only so that they know exactly what they have coming up in the next day or two.
Here's my favorite thing. For those of you who are like us that have multiple rooms, as a spa owner, when you have multiple people, my concern is the rooms are full.
Yeah.
And they have resources.
If we have an empty room, we have lots of money.
Yeah, that's us. So, you know, as much as I do care, I'm a therapist and you solopreneurs, I get it, fine. But my job as a spa owner is going, is dreamy full, is twilight full.
Yeah, are the rooms full?
Yeah.
So it, just explore it, look at it. We have had it for about...
almost 10 years.
Yeah.
It'll be 10 years next year.
And their support is good. It's difficult sometimes to get in touch with them. So what I've gotten to where I do is... I will leave a message for them, and then they'll call me back within a couple of hours. So that's a good one. The other one, if you are...
You've heard us. This is like our main boo.
Yeah, and they ought to be paying us to say this.
We're probably going to get... I'll be honest with you. Their affiliate program needs to... Yeah.
So anyway, is demand force. That is one of our number one driving advertisements out there because
that also almost got me fired.
Oh God. Well, I just didn't get it. I didn't understand. But it's also an Intuit product, which is, they were bought by Intuit, which is your QuickBooks, your Quicken Loans, all of that stuff. So they're a big company. And their customer service is outrageously good. Outrageous. They're also the ones that send the reminders of when appointments are.
They send text messages and emails. It links into Millennium, which is great. Yes. So we don't ever, it talks to Millennium. Millennium talks to it. It's fantastic.
Yes.
Like one day, I noticed it wasn't talking to each other, and I was so mad at my front desk. I'm like, you will always check that they're talking to each other.
Yeah, we didn't know.
But it's just one of those follow-up things. And, you know, you can also do your email marketing out of there. Mm-hmm. You can also, the testimonials, that's a big one.
That's the big one because they are independent, and they will send that notice to the client and say, would you please rate us? And you have this survey that you can do. And then it has where they can do private comments to you or public comments or both. And I find that those are very useful for different things. If therapists are playing music that they don't like in the rooms, like too much Christmas music, I'm going to shoot Lyric if he keeps playing Christmas music. It's like, I love Christmas music, but let's mix it in with everything else. Those are two wonderful programs. I would highly suggest you explore those. Well worth the money.
Yeah, definitely, definitely, definitely. I just got a message from Rebecca, my favorite badass body worker.
I love her.
Love her. So she is gratefully, we just launched a brand new ebook, Winning at Gift Certificates. It's free on spapreneur.com, but it is, you do have to give us your email address in exchange for it. Fair,
ooh,
right? God forbid. No, this woman, no, I'm a flat out.
Don't say her name.
I'm not going to say her name, but she goes, nothing is for free, quotation mark. I hate having to give an email address in order to get something free, quotation mark. It's not free if I have to give you my email address. In other words, I'll give you this free article in exchange for your email address where we can send you emails you didn't want in the first place. It's free. Then don't ask me for my email address. Oh, my God, lady.
Stop whining.
God almighty. Get a massage. And I think that's what I'm going to respond to her in the group.
Oh, my God.
Do you need a massage? I know a good place. I seriously, that's what I'm going to respond.
Wow.
Rebecca, of course, lovingly defended me to the hilt because she's a badass body worker. And she's secretly Daenerys Targaryen. I know she is. She has dragon. She's the mother of dragon jaw. Have you seen her hair and her fire cupping? She really is. So anyway, thank you, Rebecca, for that. But if you do want to get that free guide.
Silly.
Just again, people.
Lighten up.
God almighty. Then don't take it. Don't take the free advice. I'm not asking.
Really.
I mean, seriously, it's okay. You're not going to fit. Oh, my God. One person didn't want our free guide, Ceci. I'm so sad. Come on, people.
So, anyway, that's our answer back to them. And Mala was reading while I was rambling on. So
yeah, I'm sorry.
You're getting the real poop scoop here.
But yeah, seriously, Maggie, because you've got membership in multiple locations, I feel like it's going to be a really good idea for you to invest in a program like Millennium. There might be others out there. And if you guys find the thread on Spapreneur and want to give her suggestions, it's fine.
Yeah.
We know what we know. We know what we like. And we also know that you guys don't like. There was a certain company. I'm not going to say the name. That they really want to partner with us.
God.
Good God.
I told you to send that to the company because they need to straighten up their act.
They emailed me yesterday. I'm going to screen capture all of your comments.
Yes.
And just say, hi. This is what they think. Please fix these things and maybe we'll partner with you. So we don't take our recommendations lightly. We only recommend things that we've actually, like Profit First. I talk about that book. I talk about Amber Duggar all the time because I actually use her and she actually works. So I'm never going to recommend something that I haven't personally tried or have not gotten 1,000 different recommendations.
Yeah, y'all were pretty vocal on that.
Yeah, I was like, okay.
And if you don't know what we're talking about and you want to see it, go dig
Facebook
back
group.
In Facebook
go on the
group.
Facebook group. Seriously, all the fun's happening in the Facebook group. So anyway. Speaking of fun, it is time, Ceci, to plan for 2018.
And actually, we're almost a little late in planning for it. We should have been doing that for a while now. But, you know, we've been caught up in a 31-day challenge
and
the spa event we had that was like, oh,
England.
My God.
Then we have homegirl that's like, I don't want your free stuff. Then fine. You know, we have to deal with that.
She'll be stewing on this one for a while.
No, not really. I think it's hilarious. I'm just going to simply respond, okay. Okay, no problem here.
Oh, God. Now you need to start thinking about what is it I want to achieve in each quarter of next year. And how am I going to go about achieving it?
Yeah, you have to first look at numbers. It has to start with numbers. You can, it's funny, the first thing in the 31-day challenge was goals versus intentions, I think it was. You know, like intention mm-hmm. is something you intend to do. Goals are actually stuff you actually do. There's the difference. So I can intend to lose 100 pounds. But how am I going to do that? I had to actually have...
Yeah, you've got to have the steps. Y'all hear me say this all the time. It's a little nauseous when I have to say it all the time. Roadmap. You can't get there if you don't know how you're going to get there.
So the first thing you got to do is I like a good old-fashioned notebook. Some of you may like to do it.
Oh, my God. I cannot live without... I walk around with a steno book.
We kill so many trees. I feel bad, but I don't. Because fact, it's important. Because you got to write this stuff down.
As much as I love Lyric... You know what he's getting for Christmas? He's getting a whole stack of steno books, and I'm going to tell the boy, write that crap down because you keep forgetting to do stuff. So.
Yes. I agree. And even just
and he's only 30.
In the morning.
This is not an age thing.
You know what I do in the mornings? Every morning I write down all of the goals that I'm working on, the things that I'm expecting to have very soon, whether it is in my relationship or with my children or with my business. I write it down, and then I write the things I'm grateful for to remind myself. And it's basically your...
She's starting to sound like Oprah.
But but it works, because guess what? That Oprah does that, and she's doing pretty damn good.
Is she? Okay, I'm going to plug her. She's got a new podcast out, and I miss her so much. Soul Sunday.
Yeah.
And I've started listening, and it just is so... It's her voice.
I think that's what's wrong with America. We have no more Oprah.
She needs to run for president.
God almighty, yes.
Oh, my God.
Oprah.
Please run for president.
Seriously.
I'll work for you for free. Yeah. I will massage
you for free.
We will
be your official massage. We will drive the 3 hours. We will do it.
Let's get our plan in place.
To paper. Yes. So the first thing you need to do is you need to take a good, hard look at your numbers. You need to know how much you spent, how much you made, and did you have any left over?
Yes.
You
got to face the music. Okay, that's first. And y'all do that with Amber Duggar, and that's the way you got
to
do it.
And it's scary, but you've got to do that. Because until you get into a position where you get to write your first owner's check, like Bailey in our group, she just posted that she wrote her first check to herself.
God, that's so exciting.
It is exciting.
And I'm excited that she shared that with us.
Yeah, well, not only that, but it's like, remind you guys.
It makes you feel like a big girl.
And these businesses work for you.
Yes.
It's very important. So that's first. But the other thing is that until you know the numbers, you don't know how far you need to grow into where you need to be.
Yes.
If you're already hit, like here's an example. Some of you may actually be exactly where you need to be. So guess what? You need to push harder.
Or if that's where you're satisfied, then that's where you stay. And that's okay.
It is okay.
Growing and pushing is not for everybody, but for those who want to grow and become larger and to branch out. Now, for me, beyond the numbers, in January is, especially the very first 2 weeks, that's when I clean. I cleanse my entire 4,000 square feet. I go down to hardly any decor. I want to cleanse the energy, mm-hmm. and I start reflecting on what did not work last year. What did I put a lot of energy into, and it didn't pan out as well as I wanted it to? So perhaps I need to get rid of it.
Yeah.
So that's my cleansing time. Always reminding myself that, oh my God, Valentine's is right around the corner. Are we prepared? Have we ordered shirts? Do we have enough gift cards? And do we have our packages in place?
And do we have our schedule ready to go? Because this year, guys, Valentine's Day is on a Wednesday in the middle. So we're getting 2 weeks.
And don't forget, President's Weekend right after that. So people are off on that Monday. And so people will capitalize on that.
Yeah. So seriously, just you need to think about this now. My suggestion is this, especially for you solopreneurs, take an entire day if you can. You can do it a little bit after mm-hmm. the holidays if you need to wait. Take a day. Get out of that office. Turn off your cell phone. Do not answer the children. Do not mm-hmm. answer anybody unless like someone's literally lost an arm. And then ask yourself, what honestly can I do? Nothing. So you keep focused, okay? Okay. Yes. I'm an excellent mother. But you take the time that you need to and you work on your business. Too often, I want you guys, all of you, one of the things we're going to be talking about in our Six Pillars program coming up is setting your schedule with intention. I want you to have at least a half day, if not a full day, where you are not in the treatment rooms, but you are in there working on your business. That's the day you make your emails. That's the day you do your accounting.
Mm-hmm.
That's the day you do all this stuff. And I want you to have a full day so then you get... So tired of it that you're like, I'm going to hire someone to do this for me.
Yeah.
Yes.
And mine tends to be on Monday. I like to start my week outright. So I don't have, and even when I had a full clientele, I didn't start them until Monday afternoon.
Right.
So I put in a good 12 hours on Monday, but Monday is fresh for me. I come in renewed and I come in with purpose, and that's when I set the course for the week.
Mm-hmm. So for me, I like to do Sunday evenings. I like to do a Sunday evening plan. So what I do is I will sit down with my, sorry, I'm coughing. I will sit down with my schedule and I go, okay, what are all the things I need to do with the Tiny Humans? What are all the things I need to do with Spapreneur? What are all the things I need to do with De-Stress Express? What are the things I need to do for myself? And I make sure they're all scheduled there, because that way I'm not missing anything, because, you know, sometimes you do and it just stinks. So,
yeah.
And you can only do so much. That's the other thing. You have to have realistic goals. Like, I feel like sometimes, like, I love the book by John Acuff called Finish. And what he talks about is, too often there's plenty of books and advice on how to start goals. There's very few on how to finish them. And one of the things he says is make the goal smaller.
Yeah, I learned that about myself a long time ago. I can do things that give me instant gratification. Painting a wall, mm-hmm. vacuuming a floor.
Yeah.
Those are instant gratification. But if I have to do something that's detail-oriented, like putting together a puzzle or something, that's just not going to happen with me.
Yeah, or what you
and
do.
I had to be realistic and realize yeah. that about me.
So what you do in that situation, if you're like more like Lynn, this is what you do. Number one, you partner with somebody who doesn't mind the
yes.
long-term thing. So like for me, with money, I was very short-term with money. I partnered with Amber Duggar. We've talked about her loads.
Mm-hmm.
You know I adore the woman. And, you know, she sees the long-term picture, so she doesn't let me, my short-term mindedness get in the way. You can do that. The other thing you do is you take that big goal and you make sizable, tiny chunks that are winnable.
Yes.
I loved a friend of mine. He's in podcasting. He does the School of Podcasting, Dave Jackson. He's amazing. And one of the things, he lost like 70 pounds. And then he was telling people how, you know, who's losing. And he just mentioned the phrase, he goes, just focus 10 pounds at a time because it's really doable. Well, one of his listeners lost 150 pounds.
Wow.
And he goes, well, how'd you do it? She goes, well, I just started with 10. I did it 14 more times.
Okay. Just on a side note, the very first Oprah Soul Sunday
yeah.
is Shonda.
Shonda Rhimes.
Yes. Oh. And she lost 10 or 150 pounds, something in there. And she explains how she did it. And it was really interesting listening to her. And you can apply those same principles into other areas of your life.
Yeah. So you know, if you have a big, hairy, it's great to have a big, hairy, juicy dream. So let's say your dream this year is you want to be a six-figure massage therapist. And that is possible. That is totally, totally possible if you're in the right market and you have other people around you. And
she's staring at me while she's saying this because I'm taking a deep breath. Yes, all that's possible. You have to be committed.
Yeah, but you can't do that in your first month. So you have to break
you
out
have to
a
be
month
realistic.
Plan.
Yeah, let's be realistic.
And
did you only make $20,000 this year? Now you want to make six figures? Come on, folks. Let's be realistic about this.
So let's try to add maybe double and make $40,000. That's realistic.
But I can't say this strongly enough. If you don't write it down, it's not going to happen.
And you have to write it down over and over and over again. So every morning.
It's proven. You write it down. Put it in front of you.
Yeah. So what I've been doing in my journal, I came back from the Youpreneur conference. Let me tell you about this conference. So one of the things I loved about it was I am in a community.
This is while she was off in England, while she left me taking care of crazy people at an open house. That was a previous podcast.
Okay.
And two tiny humans and a dog that was dying. Okay.
Okay. First,
you left me.
The dog dying was not my fault. The tiny humans. Okay. That was my fault, but you loved them.
I have abandonment issues now.
You'll be okay. The open house again. I had planned this trip a year in advance. So you.
I don't care.
Okay. All right. All right.
I don't care. I'm an old woman. I don't remember dates.
Okay.
It wasn't written down.
Excuses.
Okay, fine.
Okay, anyway. So at the Youpreneur Conference, one of the things they talked about is when you want to set goals and you want to make them, is that you have to have, it was Colin Gray, and he talked about in Game of Thrones terms, he's like, you got to have a general, then you have to have a lieutenant, you have to have a sergeant, and then a soldier. So the general is like the year big goal. You know, they're the guys that see the overall picture of the battle plan. The lieutenant is the one that's mm-hmm. like your monthly goals. And those are the ones that are like, it's kind of your roadmap to get to the overall plan. The sergeant is the weekly guy, you know, your weekly thing. And then mm-hmm. your soldiers every day, what do I have to do to get those things? And if you focus on those things and you are intentionally saying every day I'm working towards this. So one of the things I decided when I was at Youpreneur was the word impact. Did you know in 2017, according to the, I think it's Webster's Dictionary, the official word is going to be complacent. It makes total sense in 2017.
I will never be complacent. That goes against my nature.
Yeah, it's kind of gross. Complacent basically means you've given up and you're ready to die.
Oh my God. Yeah. I don't know why that's such a that's a very powerful statement.
So in 2018, never be before, that way. Before I even heard that, my word in 2018 was impact. I have decided I want to have massive impact in the spa industry. Why are you laughing at me?
Mona, your entire life, you have been nothing but impact.
Yes, but now I'm going to scale it, Ceci, into bigger and brighter things. You know?
Oh, my God. I can't believe it's taken her all these years to figure out who she is.
And a very expensive trip to England. I did get a cool award there, though.
Oh, my God. That as a mother, I could not be more proud of what you got. Yeah. Did you take a picture of that and put it on Facebook?
No, there's a video. I'll put it in the group and I'll put it on the thing.
She did the ugly cry.
Oh, my God. No, I did like talk about Oprah. This is the Oprah episode. So my mentor, his name is Chris Ducker. He's this British guy.
He's so cute.
He is great. He's the best guy ever. He's the godfather spapreneur.
He's sweet.
And he's awesome. And he's just taught me a lot. And he's been there for me throughout, you know, starting spapreneur. This was kind of his idea. Actually, he goes, you should do this with your mom. I'm like, okay,
he created
sure.
a beast.
He did. And so, but he was there. My husband died. And they were super supportive. So they had this conference where a lot of us are in this membership community. And then there were other people in the UK. Like, this is the first business conference in the UK, period. They don't have these kind of conferences right there. So, like, 400 people. And so throughout the conference, he had been bringing up people in our community. Like, one of them is a dentist, her Anissa Holmes. She lives in Jamaica. So if you know any dentists that need marketing advice, this is the chick. She made $500,000 last year.
Damn.
Yeah. Well, again, dentists have huge price point too. They can afford a lot. So anyway, and other guy did this, other girl did this. So I'm thinking, so then he announces that he's going to present this year of war thing. I'm like, oh, it's going to be one of those people. So I'm sitting next to a pal of mine. His name's James and he's from Australia. He's like, I can't do the accent, but I wish I could. He goes, no, it's going to be you. And I'm like, you're lying. So and he goes and this lady and he goes, yeah, see, it's going to be you. I'm like, no, there's like a bunch of ladies that were featured. And then he comes closer to me where I'm sitting because I'm in the front. Chris does. And he starts and she's just overcome and he starts breaking down. And in my mind, I'm thinking, you mother effer, you are going to bring me on that stage. And I'm like, at least my hair is styled.
Yeah.
Like,
she says, at least I have a good dress on.
Yeah. No, seriously. This is why you can never look like a schlumpadinka. You never know when you're going to get on stage somewhere. So just always have your hair comb and your teeth brushed. Lipstick, people. It's
See,
a good
it goes
thing.
Back to what your mother tells you when you're little. Always have clean underwear on. You never know.
So I'm in a room. So I go up there and start doing the ugly cry. He and I hug for a good, like, I'd say 90 seconds. Like, we're just hugging each other. And I let go. And then all of a sudden I realize, oh, yeah, there's 400 people in the room.
It is a beautiful award. She came back all toasty and just affirmed that she was doing the right thing.
Yeah, so that's what I mean. Like, when you have a big jump start like that, and when you've, especially those of you guys who have been doing our 31 day challenge and you're rocking this holiday right now, that is your springboard into an awesome 2018.
Yeah, it's going to be a good year.
It's going to be a great year because you guys are ready. So plan for that great year.
Greatness. And what new thing are you going to do? What new thing educationally are you going to think about? I gotta tell you, we are loving bamboo.
Oh, bamboo. Oh my God, it's so good.
It is so incredible. I'm really going to try to get one of the instructors to come up here teach
and
everyone.
So gentle
and but effective.
Yes.
And I don't normally like that kind of stuff. And I want to do away with the stones because the stones just are not they're old. That's old technology.
New technology. We can keep them like for little mini stuff.
Yeah, for the mini stones we will.
But full hot stone. No.
This is so awesome.
I feel like this past year, 2017, was the year of cupping. Doesn't it feel like
Oh, my God. If I saw one more cupping mark on one of those children of mine, I was going to beat them.
Work at our place.
I'm swearing to you, they look like they have beaten to death on each other. I'm like, y'all have to cut it out or cover it up.
There could be no more fascia in their body. There could be no more.
They're crazy. They're just, it's like.
They walk around with the cups on them. And
I'm going to take pictures. You know what? I need pictures of some of this crap that goes on there. Y'all have no concept.
But like, you know, and also everybody in every massage group is talking about cupping. And yes, we know why. It's effective. It's
and
awesome.
It is
it's cool.
Good.
But what are you going to do that's going to be different? You could take a cupping class or you can find something like bamboo or something in your area.
What are you going to do to set yourself apart from the crowd.
When Lynn, when we were about 5 years in, she and Julene
took
the Ashiata
class. Oh, you told
class.
This story.
I know that, but here's the deal. I'm not going to tell the full story, but the thing is that Ashiata, we were the only place in town
yes.
in the entire like state practically for a while.
And we still are pretty much the only resource, unless you know single massage therapists here
yeah.
and there, that are certified
apart,
and trained.
And
yes.
that's why we've invested so heavily in Ashiata or
yeah.
bar
but
therapy.
Now my new love is Bamboo Fusion, and I'm saying this so I'll remember to talk to her about it. Michelle is getting up there in years of doing massage. I love Michelle. She's been with me longer than anyone. It's been a pure joy to grow with her. Mm-hmm. And she is very smart, and she's very rigid in how she learns, and she doesn't go out. She does not color outside lines. Like
no.
I do, okay?
She is an upholder.
I really need someone that knows how to do lymphatic drainage, Vater's method of lymphatic.
She's so good at
that. She would be, and I'm going to try to get her to do it. And also, it's a tough course. It takes some brains to get through that course. This
yeah.
is not for the lighthearted when it comes to school, which is me.
Mm-hmm.
I just, oh my God, yeah. it blows me away. She would be excellent, and it would take her career another 20 years. And we're seeing so much of cancer in our place now, and it's hard on us. And so I'm thinking she would do really well with this.
I think also, too, it would complement her prenatal work. It would complement
yes.
her reflexology work, certainly.
So I'm saying all this
but
I remember to talk to Michelle.
Listen how we're talking about that. She already is certified in reflexology. She's already certified in prenatal. We're discovering something that is going to allow her to use those skills even more and
yeah.
add a new modality.
Now, I can't make her do it, but I'm thinking that this is going to be right up her alley.
It probably would be, and it may be something she's mm-hmm. considered in the past. And again, she's really good about planning out her education
yes.
schedule. But you need to do that. You need to sit down, and you need to kind of, especially if you've only been in the business 2 or 3 years, at this point, you kind of know what you like, what you don't. If this is your first year, give it another year before you make an education plan.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And for those of you that have, who we were talking about earlier, you have a couple of locations, you want to talk to your people and say, where do you see yourself going? Where do you want to go? Do it over sandwiches. Bring in a whole sandwich tray. Let them make their own sandwiches. Make sure there's plenty of vegetables. You sit down and you have a powwow with them and say, so, where do you see yourself? What's interesting to you? What do you find more fascinating? The more you know about them, the better you're going to be able to sell them at the front desk.
And the more you're going to be able to see what you may be lacking. So, like, again, we, for a while there, had everybody on our staff now knows how to do cupping, pretty much. We're not lacking in that.
No, we're not lacking in cupping.
But we're lacking lymphatic drainage.
Yeah, well, that
and
is...
And it's something that's going to come up, especially as geriatrics become more and more
yes.
important.
Lymphatic is, like I said, a tough field, but I think it's going to start coming out as we all age more and as cancer becomes even more
prevalent. Or diabetes. I'm just thinking my late husband, his legs were so swollen, lymphatic would
yeah.
have at least... eased it.
Yeah.
You know, so and just, it's just a lot of these things and healthcare concerns, you know, the bodies yeah. are naturally inflamed. So
you yeah. need to look at that. And hey, what about attending a trade conference like FSMTA, the Florida State Massage Therapy? AMTA.
What is it? The Massage World or the.
Yeah, something like that. But let me tell you, yeah. FSMTA is like the cream of the crop as far as I'm concerned. I've been down to that and it is well put together. It is represented
yeah,
well.
And often you can take classes to get CEUs, which
oh,
is
yeah,
great.
Yeah.
You know, check with your local accountant. You should have one. You know, what can be rid off, what can't be. But it's a great time, too, to also fellowship with other massage therapists. I love going to conferences. Like
aren't you funny? I think they're all crazy, so I make a point of not doing
that. No.
But I'll meet up with you guys if we go down there and y'all go down there.
We could do a spapreneur meetup.
Yeah, we'll
buy your own drinks, though. Yeah, you buy your own drinks.
That's right.
Yeah, no. But like, I go to conferences. So again, I'm into podcasting, so I go to podcast conferences. It's really fun for a while to go ahead and be with people who understand you're weird. You know, sometimes
yeah,
it's nice.
I'm out there and I'm strange, but there are some really weird ones.
Well, again, that's why
weird.
We didn't let that one girl in the group that one time.
So,
yes.
Anyway.
So, yeah. So plan out your year, plan out your trips. The other thing you should consider is planning out, again, the you know, we go over like 6 pillars, new ways of getting new clients in. But more importantly, how are you going to keep them? How's
yeah.
your retention strategy? You really need to look at the number and you need to see how many people. You have retained that client when they've seen you 6 times. That's what we use in our day spa because that's mm-hmm. 1.5 packages. Mm-hmm. If they come in 6 times, we've got them.
Okay. Now, I'm going to step on some toes when I say this, but I want you to hear me. And this is mostly for your solopreneurs that if you don't have good retention, you need to go to someone that's going to give you the honest, bloody truth. Massage them and tell them to give you feedback. You may not be as good as you think you are, and you may need to tune up and find out where you're weak in your massage. So I don't like saying that, but sometimes we think we're better than we are.
I agree, especially if you're considering a price increase. That could be part of your 2018 plan. But when I know my therapists are ready for price increase is when we can't fit people onto their table.
Yeah. Yep.
You know, when they've taken a new modality and it's that good, like Jody. You know
but
I mean?
We don't even increase it then. We get them in at a basic price and then say, got to get it now before we do take it up to the specialty pricing. And we all talk about it. She gave almost all of us in the place a session. So we're all going, oh my God.
If you've never had the warm bamboo, it's fantastic. Because it's like it's these rods and then like she does the tapoma, but then like she just
weird.
Feels
the
out.
Warmth stays with you for hours.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Yeah, bamboo fusion is definitely where my heart's at right now.
It makes me happy.
So start thinking about that. So we're talking about kind of basically the first 90 days here. Mm-hmm. So get Valentine's done. You got to get that under your belt so that you don't have to fuss and worry about it. You need to start doing that now. Yep. Order your gift certificates for it now.
Because Mr. Prince is going to be running special because people aren't ordering supplies right now.
They just came off of a 60%. So keep watching for that.
Well, they just advertise on TV. They do, I think it's like you put in holiday or
TV?
Gift card. They're doing TV ads.
We are making them too much money. Damn it.
It's funny. You know how you were asking for feedback? The other thing you can do is what I've been doing lately is I hand selected a group of spapreneurs and I've been having 1-hour conversation with them. Mm-hmm. That's where I came up with a lot of these ideas. And lovely Grace. We love our Grace.
Oh, she's so cute.
She told me that we should get referrals from Vista Prince. So I'm going to look into it because we've sent them up. But the other thing.
But we honestly love them. Even if we don't get it, we love them.
Yeah, we love them.
I mean, they're good.
But I think you guys should do the same thing. Take your 3 best clients and take them out to lunch and ask them honest questions about your business. Or take your clients that are business savvy. Take them out to lunch.
Now we're going all the way back to the first 2 episodes of our podcast. It does you well to go back and revisit those, your mentor group. Because they can, and only if you're open to constructive criticism and they can give you honest feedback. It doesn't mean you have to do everything they're saying, but it gives you a sounding board and gives you new ideas.
Yeah, and you've got to be open to it. And sometimes it's uncomfortable and sometimes you don't like it. And sometimes, but it's in the uncomfort that is when big change happens.
Well, and I tell people, you know, give me your ideas. Tell me what you want. But those who know me well, like Mona and some others, know that you can tell me, but I need to go off and think about it for a while. I need it to gel in my mind. And if I can wrap my brain around it, normally I'll come back and go, yeah, okay, yeah, we can do that. Sometimes I'll come back and say, no, and this is why I don't want to do it. I give them a reason why, because I want them to be honored and know that I took it seriously. And it's usually because it's just not the right time for it.
Right. Or it just doesn't fit in with your business model.
So we're giving you a few things to go ahead and start scheduling now.
Yeah. And go ahead.
Hey,
and,
you know what, Mona?
What?
They could do like a couple of people coming over, business people, now.
They could.
And say, and by the way, have you gotten your gift certificates yet?
Yep. Seriously, and these are all things that you could do that are pretty inexpensive and ways to go. So let's just summarize just the things we want to do. Look at your numbers and be honest with your numbers. Your numbers include your money and your retention.
And if you don't have a way of looking at your numbers, that's the very first thing you're going to do is set up an accounting system.
And if you don't have one, Amber Duggar, I cannot say enough good things about that woman. I do not make any money by telling you about her. Okay,
no,
guys?
No, really but I said this in the podcast when she first started talking about Amber. I choked when Mona told me what she was going to pay, but Mona's actually made money from listening to Amber. So this has been a very positive
force. And significant amount
Well,
of debt.
And as a mother, you worry about your children no matter what age they are. I now know Mona can go forth in the world and I don't have to worry about her. Yeah. That's a very big comfort. Now, if I just get my little Rachel on the bandwagon.
Rachel's her own thing. So do that. You've got to know your numbers. And you got to track your numbers daily, guys. How many massages came in? How many calls? If you're small and if you can track how many calls came in, how many emails have you sent out? And track those numbers, because I guarantee you it's not enough. I guarantee you, all of you are like, oh my God, I can't send the emails. Yes, you can. Send more than you think. People will ignore them if they don't want them. Yeah, or they'll unsubscribe.
So don't worry about, oh my God, I'm getting too many. Just send it.
Because I guarantee you're going to still send too few. The next thing you do is, again, you think about, dream big. And say, okay, this year, what is the one thing I'm going to focus on? And focus on one thing, whether it be continuing education, whether it is I'm going to get this many number of new clients, or focus on one thing. Now, you can do some subsets. So let's say my focus is I want 50 new clients this year. Mm-hmm. That's a reasonable number if it's an overall day spa with maybe like 2 to 3 people, right?
Right.
Okay, because you split between them. So then how am I going to do that? Well, now, number one, maybe taking a new class, because I need to learn some new skills to attract a new client base. So maybe taking a prenatal class so I get prenatal clients in.
That's right.
Okay. Maybe I do more emphasis on educating.
Or maybe I go and take ashiatsu so that I can work on larger clients without killing myself and give them the satisfaction that they need.
Exactly. Maybe, you know, again, lymphatic drainage, so many bamboo fusion, so many different options that save your hands. The next thing that you want to consider is, again, what things do I need to do monthly, weekly, and daily to reach that goal?
Yes.
So go back
and
to-
And that should involve a pen and paper.
Get yourself a notebook. I love myself a good notebook. You can go to Target.
I'm just all about a little steno pad, because I can just flip those pages, turn the book over, do the pages more. And then I'm like, let me go back and look at some of these pages, see if I missed anything. Sometimes I'm like, wow, I didn't realize I'd written that down.
Yeah. And sometimes you don't refer back. Like a lot of times my notes, I'll refer back, but I won't refer back. Like I take online courses about marketing, things like that. Sometimes I'll refer back. Sometimes I won't. But just writing the stuff down helps me remember.
Yes.
So do that too. And then allow yourself to dream big, but then also go back and go, okay, what's honestly realistic? It's okay to dream small.
Yes, yes, yes. So, and don't forget in all of that, that your Valentine's needs to be all sewn up, done. Sew it up.
Same things you do at holiday, you do at Valentine's Day. Packages. Yeah. You're going to need to focus more on couples things. That's just the
Well, and bottom line, go back to your 31-day challenge. Go through it again for Valentine's.
Yeah, pretty much. And then the only other thing that I would add is get yourself available to be rubbing some people, because that's when appointments are going to be heavy.
Yes.
And get yourself booked up enough, and then have a plan
to get them back in.
To get them back in. But then have a plan for this. This is the verbiage you use on that man that's going to call you on Valentine's Day because he forgot. Because God forbid he doesn't remember. The Valentine's Day is the 14th every year. This is what you tell him. Okay, we have no openings. And he's going to whine and cry and beg you and plead you. And
I've called all the other places. They said the same thing. Okay, look, we're going to teach you something.
We're going to teach you something. I want you to buy a gift certificate for your lady. We're going to buy it. She's never going to know. I'll even set the day, like the day you bought it, like 2 days from now, just in case she asks. Okay? You can do this. You can fudge those numbers. And then you tell him, you're going to be hero tonight giving this to her at dinner. And then when she comes into the massage a couple months from now, she's going to love you then. Because she's going to be reminded what you did. You're a hero twice. Boom. That's how you sell gift certificates at Valentine's Day.
You put it in a dozen roses, tuck it in there instead of the little florist card, and say, here, baby, I was thinking about you all day.
That's right. That's right. So, and then you remind him, this makes a damn good birthday gift too. Just seriously, you know, don't forget, guys, plan your birthday notices, plan anniversaries, plan these things. But if you plan and you execute even just half of your plans, you'll be so much far ahead than where you were this past year.
Okay. I want to wrap this up by giving you one more thing I want you to do. One thing. How are you going to take care of yourself?
Oh, that's so important.
Are you going to exercise it? Are you going to eat a little bit differently? Are you going to commit to getting a massage once a week?
Are you going to arrange your schedule to be more effective? A lot of us are mothers. So I've arranged my schedule every day but Wednesdays, because that's the day my dad picks them up, Pawpaw Day. I am there picking up my children from school, because that was the one thing I've always wanted to do when I worked at corporate America. I hated that. I couldn't do that. I'm now the one that does that every day. And it's and as much as I hate that carpool line, I love their faces because they're so excited to see you. And so, you know, if that's important to you, make your schedule the way you need to.
And you have to do it as an appointment. Mona's got it in her calendar. We share a calendar. And it is an appointment so that you don't have an excuse. You don't move that appointment.
No.
So ask yourself realistically, what do I want to do to take care of myself? You interviewed one young lady a couple of weeks ago, and she had five children. I challenge you.
Yeah.
Those children need to know that you take care of yourself. Otherwise, they won't take care of themselves.
Yeah.
We need to be the example. We need to lead by example.
So one thing I do to take care of myself, honestly, is I have taken improv classes and love them. I'm now on two improv teams, and that's my fun thing to do. Ceci goes to the Lake House.
Yep.
And Ceci works out with Joey.
And that, you know, and let's say you don't have a lot of money and you do have five kids. So you teach those children. You put up a little sign that says, "Mommy is not here," and you sit in the chair and you read your magazine and
you
drink
your cocoa.
Or you
treat yourself to a book at the library.
Yes, or you do something, and they can be there, but when they come to you whining, you go, I am not here right now. And you'll find that most things resolve themselves pretty quickly.
Same thing with your staff. I'll never forget. I think it was Stan that taught me this. Or maybe it was
I
Michelle.
I love Stan.
Maybe it was Michelle Pippen.
You know he's going to be retiring next year.
Yeah, I don't like that. I
love him.
He's great.
The only thing I asked of him was, I said, before you retire, you have to come do a podcast with the three of us.
Oh, yeah.
It would be so much fun.
Just stories alone. And he's very, very smart when it comes to massage.
Yes.
Very, very smart. But one
to
of the
business.
Yeah, business in general. He's had several successful businesses. But
yes.
One of the things I loved is that whenever whether it's an employer, an independent contractor, or somebody in your business wants your time, you ask them, okay, but can I see you at the end of your whatever work day is? And I guarantee you, they're not going to stick around long enough. If it's that important to them, they'll stick around long enough, and then you know it's a real concern. Or if they're willing to come in on their day off. Like, yeah. You know, that's when you know. But if they're not, it's not that big of a concern. Same thing with your kids. You just have to set up reasonable boundaries. So again, like Wednesdays are my day where I don't pick up the kids. I know that I can go out with my boyfriend. Or like last night I went out with my girlfriend, Angie. You know, we had Mexican food. And it's not a big thing. But, you know, I wanted the time with my friend.
And let me stress this. It is important in this day and age when we think we have to do everything for our children and our family to make them the best that they can be. The best thing you can do is show them by example that I need to take care of myself or I cannot take care of you.
Yeah.
So important.
So, so important. So real quick, if you are ready to start a great game plan for 2018, but you're not sure exactly what you want to do and you want my help, here's two ways to do it. One is I do offer private one-on-one coaching. It is not terribly expensive, but for some of you, it's a leap. But you get two 90-minute sessions. You can go to spapreneur.com/coaching. Sign up for a pre-interview because I like to see if we mesh well before we do that.
Yes.
The other thing that's a more budget-friendly option and it's still great is we are doing our six pillars program. So we're focusing on six pillars of spa success, including new clients, retaining the clients, getting referrals, managing your money, best business practices.
Are you all talking at one time, meeting at one time?
Yes. Yeah, so we'll meet weekly.
See,
with
I love that. I wish I'd had that because then you're bouncing ideas back and forth and getting good stuff and feeling supported.
They'll also get like private lessons. Like again, yes. They'll get a Valentine's Day plan. Like this is what we're doing. So they'll get checklists. So kind of like think of the 31-day challenge on like steroids. So that's a much lower cost. It actually costs less than 1 month of my one-on-one coaching.
And I would imagine that also, I mean, genuine folks, she had told me some about this, but I didn't know a whole lot about it. I would think also if they have a specific problem, they can put it out there and y'all can discuss it.
Exactly. And live time. Yeah. So it'll be video chats and then all those will be recorded in case. And it's one of those things where you need to make whatever time we have our video chat. You don't take appointments during that time. That's really important.
Yeah.
You've invested this money.
No,
and
I like that.
And it's just for 12 weeks, but it's just a matter of getting you guys in the habit of really focusing
awesome.
On those things. I'm really excited about it. I hope you guys take me up on this because I've worked really hard on this program. So,
no, it just.
Guys,
do you want to be successful or not?
Yeah, there's only so much, and I'm going to be honest with you. We give a lot of value with our free content, whether it's our free content upgrades or, you know, like our gift certificate books or whatever it is, or, you know, like the challenge.
But if you want to step outside that box and become extraordinary, then you need to
invest. You got to invest the time and the money. So if you're ready, go to, this is episode 27, so spapreneur.com/027 and the link to that program will be there and it's also in our Facebook.
Okay, I gotta tell you one funny before we go.
Of course.
This cracked me up. I don't know why I found it so funny, but still it's hysterically funny. This lady comes in and wants to get massage and tells my therapist, No, you cannot use oil. I'm on a fat-free diet. Wait a minute. wait a minute, are you going to drink this oil? What the hell are you going to do? She would not let us rub her with any kind of oils.
So I, last year, remember I was working with the that chiropractor and yes. they did that weird diet program. That was one of their things was, is that they would not let them use any kind of like cream with any oil in it at all. They had some
what?
Scientific thing. I looked at them like, y'all are crazy.
What the hell is, oh my
Lord. Notice I do not work with them anymore. I just, oh, you know, like, again, I would make more money.
I didn't realize that. I should have asked her if she was part of that group.
Probably. And that's fine. No, I mean, it's
oh, my God.
But that's the, but dude, seriously, I just, people, I love human
you
beings.
You just have to laugh.
Yeah.
That's you're crazy.
Should be your goal in 2018.
It's a good thing she was with somebody else because I would have blatantly laughed in her face. I mean, I just couldn't help myself.
Who was she with?
Quayla.
Oh, Quayla.
And Quayla's so sweet and kind that Quayla said, I will go find something else. God. Never mind.
God,
okay.
People are fun. Anyway, we'll talk to y'all later.
All right. Bye.
Need more actionable steps to get your spa headed in the right direction? Head to spapreneur.com. We've got the tools, tricks, and methods to making your spa as successful as it can be. Spapreneur.com.